गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैड डिस्कस्ड स्ट्रिंग, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द स्टोरेज क्लास। वी यूज वेरिएबल्स टू स्टोर वैल्यूज टू प्रोसेस ड्यूरिंग द प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूशन। वन ऑफ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट पोजेसेस ईच वेरिएबल दैट इज इट्स स्टोरेज क्लास। With the storage class definition, the value contains its lifetime and its visibility as well as scope. The visibility and scope both are same in two words.
Let's take example of a storage class. As we see that visibility and scope, these are the consideration for the storage classes. So I am giving some examples. By example it will be more clear. A storage class 1.c. Example of local storage class. Hash include stdio.h FUNC1 void. Void FUNC2 void. क्या आ गया? कौन सा कीड़ा आ गया? इसको हटा दो। INT m is equal to 1000. Here I have declared a variable m with an initialization of 1000, and then moving the control to the FUNC2, and then printf percent d backslash l m. So this is the main function. Afterwards I am starting void FUNC1 void. INT m is equal to 10. Printf backslash n percent d. Here I have made two lines gap and then backslash n comma m semicolon, and this function is completed. Then void FUNC2 void here int m is equal to 100. FUNC1 and then printf %d / n, m. F. So this has been completed. In this example we are using three functions, one main function and two functions, namely func1 and func2, FUNC1 and FUNC2. Initially control will go to the M. Here it is taking instruction to declare a variable M with an initialization 1000. Afterwards it is getting to go to the function 2, so it will move to func2. Here in func2 it is getting a value of 100 and getting the instruction to move to the function 1. So it is here function 1, here it is getting M is equal to 1. In all these three functions we are seeing everywhere the function's visibility or lifetime are local, confined to the braces and confined to this braces. So whenever the control is here, it has a value of 1000. So initially it was here, then moved to here, then here. Here it is getting M is equal to 10, and the next instruction is to print, to show what you have. So it will show M is equal to 10. So initially it will give the result 10. Afterwards it will move to there from where it has come. It has come from function 2. So it will move here, and here function 1. Afterwards it will go next statement, and here it has to being asked to show what you have. Here it will show 100. So next output will be 100, and afterwards it will move back to the main function from where it has been sent. So here in next function it again asks what you have. Here, since here it has 1000, so it will show 1000. So you will see the result will be in such a order that in first it will show 10, second 100, and third 1000. It requires semicolon.
So now program is complete, and let's execute that. It is here, okay, control F9. Let's see the result, alt F5. So as I had described, in the first it will print 10, then 100, afterwards 1000. So this is the local or auto variable or the storage class. Let's move to the second example, that is save as storage class 2.C. So we will start
use of global storage class has include stdio.h int fun1 void int fun2 void int fun3 void. So these are three functions, and then a global variable x which is of type integer. So this three function and the variable is global. Now I start main function, and here I am assigning 10. X is equal to 10. Printf n x is equal to %d / n comma x. Printf double quotes x is equal to %d / n fun1 printf x is equal to %d / n fun2 printf x equal to %d / n comma fun3. To hold the result, get ch int fun1 void x is equal to x plus 1 int fun2 void int f. Here it is again declared, so it is local. Local, and it gets fresh initialization x is equal to 1 and return x. Oh. 10. In this case, it is global. So this is the program. Let's put here return is equal to 0, return 0, and so on, and it gets said it asks for return is equal to 0. So now control F9. So this is the 10, 11, 1, 21. Why so? Here we have initialized this global variable with 10. So in this case it is showing 10 in first case. Afterwards in func1 we are just adding 1 to this global variable. So it is showing here 11, but in this case, I mean in func2, it has re-declared as a global within this demarcation, within this block. So it is just only showing 1 here, and again the value which we have inserted, that is going to this variable which have earlier 11. So 11 plus 10, it means it is giving 21. So this is the way by which we use a variable in many ways. So the example one was of local or auto storage class, and this one is of global storage class. The third one which I am giving you, that is for a static storage class. So file save as se_3.c. So in this category the variable retain its value between different function calls. So we will see through this example. This is a local variable declared inside the main function, and now we are using a loop of 3 iterations. I is equal to 1, I less than equal to 3, I plus plus, and the value will come from stat, the function defined above, semicolon get ch clean and return. So this is a small program. Now we write void the stat void static int x is equal to 0, x is equal to x plus 1, printf. So this is the program. Save, control F 9. So here the output is x is equal to 1, 2, 3. In each iteration it is getting incremented. Do you know why so? Since it is written here static, if it will be removed like this, here it is simply int, there is no extra word, extra instruction, control F9, and it is giving x equal to 1111. So I hope you all have understood the difference of using the keyword static and deleting the static. So static is a storage type in which the variable retains its value between different function calls. That is, when for the first time a function is called, a static variable is created with initial value 0, and in subsequent calls it retains its present value, and as per instruction it does there. So this is all about our storage class. Okay, we will meet in next session.